for giving me this opportunity to present my research, and my research is about an open question which hasn't been yet solved, which is about primordial magnetic field. The motivation for this research, which is like to investigate primordial magnetic field or inflationary magnetogenesis in the context of natural inflation, was the result of ICEP2, because ICEP2 favored chaotic inflation, like natural inflation or large field inflation. However, we did also after Planck 2015, which already disproved ICEP2, we did the same research of R square inflation, which is the Starbinsky inflation. So inflation cosmology, since the other speaker already talked about it, we can skip over this. And the two constraints for inflation is that the universe follow rapid way of expansion, like exponential, and it lasts enough time to be consistent with observation, with cosmological observation. And this is what is called slow rule inflation. The standard scalar field inflation can be defined by this Lagrangian, and by just applying Lagrangian analysis, we can find this equation function for scalar field. This kind of inflation, which is the simple inflation, is really very successful, and it give a good description to the observations. But it cannot explain the primordial magnetic field if it was generated during the inflationary era. So these are some models of primordial generation, but all of the post-inflation model may suffer from causality problem. Why? Because primordial magnetic field is observed everywhere, in all scale. So if we assume it is scale invariant, we have to think about inflationary magnetogenesis. That means we have to think about the generation of primordial magnetic field from the inflationary era. So inflationary magnetogenesis, and this is the problem of inflationary magnetogenesis. If the magnetic field is generated in inflation era, then it will get diluted because of the inflation. So we have to, because the electromagnetic field is conformally symmetric, so we need to break the conformal symmetry during this period. And to do that, we introduced a coupling function between the scalar field and the vector field, which is the electromagnetic vector. And this function is retained to one at the end of inflation. So we just basically introduced this part in the Lagrangian and redo everything. And the definition of coupling function can be defined by this function. So it is a potential dependent. So it depends on the inflationary potential. So for this reason, we plug here, like you know, the large field inflation or natural inflation. And this is just, you know, how to calculate this, the power spectrum of magnetic field and electric field. And at the end of inflation, we have to make sure that we don't have back reaction problem, at which the energy of magnetic field and energy of electric field should be less than the energy of inflation itself. So this is just the ICEP2 and Planck 2014, and ICEP2 kicks array and plan 2015 and plan 2015. In fact, we started this from Bicep 2 and they announced B mode. Then after, in September 2014, blank, like, try or give a big doubt about this, you know, discovery. Then in February 2015, this was almost this paper or this book. So, doing or calculating the power spectrum for electric field and magnetic field for large field insulation shows that this model suffer from the back reaction, because you can see that electric field is much higher than the magnetic field. And by the way, magnetic field is scale invariant here. And this is the spectrum also with as a function of wave number. For large, this is for large inflation at P equal to 2. This is for nature inflation. And again, it also suffer from the back reaction, because we are interested, or we are interested in low K, because we are interested in long wavelength, in super Hubble horizon. So for long wavelength, we have low K. So we are interested in this area, and this area you can see electric field is much higher than magnetic field. Except in a short range of value of the magnitude of potential. You see, this is the magnitude of potential. At this short range, the electric field spectrum fall below the magnetic field. But this is really is a short range. And also, the key value is short, like we have just this short range at which we can avoid the back reaction problem. So, you know, the problem of this model is that this is just a short range of K. But in inflation, we can go beyond this, like smaller than this K. So, finally, after Planck 2015, I did the same research, but by using the R square inflation. And here you can see that we can avoid the back reaction problem, because electric magnetic field is more than the electric field, especially if H, which is the rate of expansion, Hubble parameter, is less than H to the minus 5. And this is the upper bound by Planck 2015 and by most of the conventional observations. So the upper bound of H is 10 to the minus 5 Planck mass. And you can see here, for the, if I choose the, like, the exact value, the upper limit, then we will get this value of magnetic field energy at the end of inflation. So by at the end of inflation, we say that the, you know, the conformal symmetry is resumed. That means from the end of inflation up to now, we can rescale the present magnetic field to that value. And that is by, that is really consistent with the present magnetic field announced by Planck, which is 10 to the minus 9. And also, we made sure that there is no back reaction problem, because both electric field and magnetic field less than the energy of insulation at the end of insulation. Also, we constrain the reheating temperature, and it lies almost in the middle of Planck 2015 results, which is here, for almost all possible value of equation of state parameter. This is the summary that we can, like, create